You are about to start the audiobook of the book review of The Lover, a famous work by Marguerite Duras. During this reading, you will first discover a brief context of the work and its author. Then, a summary of the work will be presented, followed by an analysis of the characters and the key points of the novel. Once these different points have been addressed, all that remains is to conclude this listening session with a few questions that may further fuel your reflection. The author. Marguerite Duras, 1914-1996, née Marguerite Donadieu, born in Cochinchina, a former region of French Indochina, was one of the most original and influential novelists of the 20th century. She advocated a pared-down writing style, used recurring characters, and built the corpus of her works around the fundamental themes of memory and forgetting, as well as rewriting and destruction. Her most famous and widely studied novels are The Seawall, 1950, Moderato Contabile, 1958, and The Lover, winner of France's prestigious Prix Goncourt in 1984. She also contributed to the theater, La Musica, Eden Cinema, and The Cinema, where she employed a radical and highly personal style, India Song, Destroy, She Said, The Lorry. The work. Published in 1984, The Lover won the Prix Goncourt that year. This autobiographical novel tells the story of a French teenage girl living in Indochina and her encounter with a young Chinese heir, which will influence the rest of her life. He introduces her to the pleasures of love. Their relationship, which is forbidden by the young girl's family, the man's father, and colonial society, ends when she must return to France, leaving him still in love with her. This novel was met with dizzying success. It has sold almost 3 million copies and been translated into more than 40 languages. Summary. In the autumn of her life, a woman looks back on her year-and-a-half-long relationship with her first lover. The meeting. In the 1930s, a 15-and-a-half-year-old girl is living in French Indochina with her mother and two brothers. Her father died when she was younger. She is enrolled at the French school and is boarding in the state of Saigon, where there are a number of mixed-race girls. One of the other girls living at the boarding school is Helene Lagonel, who is 2 years older than the narrator and a source of physical attraction for her. At the end of the school holidays, when she is traveling by ferry across the Mekong Delta to go from Sadek back to the boarding school in Saigon, she notices a very stylish young man watching her from a black limousine. Although he is dressed like a European, he is not white, he is Chinese, and will become her first lover. He is quick to approach her and, once they have introduced themselves, he offers to take her back to Saigon in his limousine, which she accepts without a great deal of enthusiasm. However, from this moment on, the teenage girl will always be driven to her boarding school in this chauffeured car, and will dine at the most stylish spots in town with the Chinese man. The relationship. One day, the young man takes her to his studio apartment in Cholen, the Chinese capital of French Indochina. From then on, they meet there to make love in secret. The young girl feels that she gains a deeper knowledge of God through this act. He is madly in love with her, while she desires him, partly for his money. But they never talk about what they are doing, aware that their relationship has no future. They are not from the same race, and the young girl is 12 years younger than her lover, even without taking into account the fact that the man's father is formally opposed to their union. Having planned to marry his son to a rich Chinese heiress, he wants to send the girl back to France. She does not protest, and he will end up getting his way. Meanwhile, the girl's mother's attitude is ambiguous. When she discovers that her daughter is seeing a rich young Chinese man, she suspects that they are sleeping together and, encouraged by her eldest son, beats the child who is dishonoring her. However, her attraction to money gets the better of her suspicion and, after being warned about her daughter's frequent absences, asks the headmistress of the boarding school to let her come and go as she pleases. Nonetheless, when the Chinese man ends up meeting the young girl's family, none of them speak to him, even though they had not hesitated to take advantage of his money. Soon, the Chinese man offers the young girl, with whom he is hopelessly besotted, a ring with a very valuable diamond. This puts an end to the comments of the supervisors at the boarding school, not because the young girl wears it on the ring finger of her left hand, where engagement rings are worn, but because of the very high value of the jewel. The departure for France. In 1931, after sitting her exams, the young girl, who is now 18, leaves Saigon and sets off back to France by boat. From the moment her departure date is set, The lovers continue to see each other but do not make love because the man feels that he is no longer capable of it. When the boat sets off, she cries without letting her family see and watches her lover getting further away. Her journey will last 24 days. In 1942, her little brother dies from pneumonia at the age of 27. The young girl sees this as her older brother's fault, according to her, by frightening, threatening, and beating him during their childhood. He made the young man weak and vulnerable.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.